Hello and happy new year to you and welcome back to my podcast. I've taken a wee 3 week break and I'm back today. It is the, I want to say 12th of January, something like that, 2023. So we've been in the new year nearly 2 weeks now and I haven't podcasted, but I have been busy as usual and I've got lots to share today, including this squishy cushion that I am clutching. You've possibly seen it before. It is my In The Groove cushion. And this Monday, I noticed that this Monday coming, the 16th of January, is noted as Blue Monday, which is statistically the day that everyone is most depressed after Christmas. So I thought this Monday I would cheer everyone up and I'm giving away the free pattern for this cushion. It has not yet been published on its own. It's currently available as part of my colour and crochet course. And there's a few patterns in that course just to get you started with colour. And this Monday, I'm going to give away the individual pattern, PDF, crochet pattern for the cushion. So if you are subscribed to my mailing list, there's nothing you need to do. You will automatically be given the code for the cushion on Monday. And if you are not subscribed to my mailing list, go and hop on that. I'll put it as the first link in the description down below. So go hop on my mailing list and this free pattern will be heading your way on Monday. So that's exciting, something to look forward to, free pattern. It's an Aran weight cushion and I worked it in 6 colours. I used paint box yarns, Aran weight, worsted weight wool, and that is 100% wool yarn, and I got that from Lovecrafts. It's their own brand yarn, and I just used these 6 colours, 6 bold colours, but as with most of my patterns, there are all sorts of options at the end of the pattern. You can take it your way, you could stash bust this, you could make it scrappy, you could make a blanket once you've got the pattern repeat. You can make a blanket with it. There is all sorts that you could do with this one. And both sides are the same and they are just crocheted together with a double crochet join. Nice and simple. And again, you could make that fancier. You could add a picot border, you could stick pom-poms on it. Do what you like. That is what I really like to encourage folks to do with my patterns, is here's the pattern, here's the information you need, why not go and do this? I do really like to include that, and I love it when you share with me what you've made and the changes you've made, and it's always lovely to see. And even if you've just followed along and used the exact yarn I have and made it to the specifications I have, share those photos with me as well, because they're good to see too. I always love to see your photos, and I have been sharing one photo a week in my emails. On a Friday morning, my crochet chit chat is my Friday morning newsletter. So if you're subscribing for the pattern, you'll get that newsletter every Friday as well. And it has a bit of news, it has a crochet tip, and I always share a pattern from one of you. So tag me if you make anything and I will share that. And if you're not on social media, there is my email address is in the description here as well. And you can email me your photos and I will include those. Today is really cold, hence the scarf. The hat is partly because it's cold and partly because my hair is literally, honestly, it's sitting about that high above my head. I don't know what I did in my sleep, but I just woke up and it was all coming out. But the back is absolutely flattened and everything around here is just whew. So yeah, the hat is taming the hair, keeping me cozy. It's wet, it's windy. It's 3 degrees or something, which is not as cold as some folks in Canada and Scandinavia, I know, but it's cold enough for me. And I'm drinking Twinings Focus Tea, which is pineapple, mango and ginseng, I believe. Something like that. It's quite fruity. And most importantly, it's warm. So I will reluctantly put it down so I can show you some other things. So definitely sign up for that. I will pop that over to there. I've finished something and I don't know if I started these on the last podcast. I've been wearing them, which is why they are kind of loose and baggy and slightly fluffed up on the soles. I think I was either just about to start or I had the pattern and I shared the pattern with you. It's a pattern by Stone Knits, who is Charlotte Stone, and the pattern is Climb Every Mountain Socks, and these are little cable cars, and I accidentally made them in a very retro 80s colourway. It's not necessarily what I was aiming for. It really wasn't until I got into this that I thought, oh my goodness, that is so 80s, isn't it? I'm going to make them again next Christmas, and I'm going to start late November, early December, have them ready for Christmas, because I finished these, I think, on the 2nd or 3rd of January. So, and I would love to make them in, yeah, I guess a colour similar to my hat, a nice blue, pale sky colour, and have those cable cars really pop. And I learned so much with these, with my tension. It's stranded colour work, and this is all, it's all a little bit loose. I'm not very happy with it. And then there's some bits that are bunched up and tight. So I did learn a lot. I hadn't done colour work for a wee while. And most of the colour work which I do is more traditional fair isle, which is kind of more this kind of gaps between the colours. Whereas here, there's large gaps of one colour, and obviously you've got to carry, say, the brown. You've got to carry the brown on the back between those two points, and getting that tension right, I found quite tricky. So I learnt a lot. I also missed a little bit in the pattern about doing a decrease. Where was it? After the colour work, there was a decrease. So my foot did end up a lot wider. I think there's 4 or 6 stitches, too many, could even be 8, too many on the sock compared with the leg. I also spilled coffee on them somewhere, I think it's this one. Yeah, I got coffee all down it. One day when I was knitting them, I managed to just spill coffee as I was drinking it, all over the white bit, of course. So these are headed for the wash. I wore them, I got them finished on the 2nd, so I managed to wear them for a good few days before it was time to pack up the Christmas things. So I'm chuffed with that. And I'll definitely make them again. I would thoroughly recommend the pattern. I also forgot, I got carried away with the stripes. There should be a similar thing to this sort of wavy thing going on before the toes. And I forgot about that. I was so determined to get them finished that I forgot. But other than that, yeah. Go on, try new things. If you've not done stranded colour work, try it. What could go wrong? You'll learn. It might not be pretty at first like those, but they're for me, so it doesn't matter. Try not to compare yourself with other folks and their beautiful tension. The only way you're going to get better at it is by doing, right? So, I really enjoy it. That's the one thing that made me want to learn to knit was colour work. And I absolutely love it. So I think I'll jump in and show you the next colour work knitting pattern. I do have a fair bit of knitting today. I have been crocheting. The main thing that I have been crocheting I have to keep secret for another maybe 6 weeks. So I'm sorry about that. So I have been knitting when I haven't been crocheting. I have got some crochet as well. But is there one more? No, there are 2 more knitting projects. I'll dive in with the next one. It's in this gorgeous bag, which I got from SoRaimi. SoRaimi on Instagram, on Etsy. She is Rachel, and she lives just across in Fife, which is not too far from me. And I received her Christmas mystery box, which I did manage to keep until Christmas Eve. And I pulled it out and I opened it on Christmas Eve once I'd done all the jobs. It was about 9 o'clock at night, Christmas Eve. I sat down with that and I watched the Sewing Bee Christmas special, and I knitted a bit on these socks, and I opened this. I've not got the yarn with me, but there was the project bag, a little skein of yarn in these kind of colours. There were a couple of little soy candles, some chocolates. I'm to think now. Perhaps there was something else, I can't remember. It was lovely anyway, it's fully lined. Here you can see SoRaimi. And yeah, it's just gorgeous bag. Can you see that it's shiny as well? The gold, yeah, you can. That gold is shimmery. So in here, I have currently got my next colourwork project. It's not a sock, it's actually a pair of fingerless mitts. And this morning I just finished the bind off on the finger bit. This is where the thumb is, and it's on a bit of scrap yarn because I have to go round and pick up those stitches. But in the meantime, I will show you it on. I can do that now. Ta-da! Look! Aren't they gorgeous? And you can see, although they haven't been blocked, you can see I have got the tension much better on these. Still room for improvement. There's some bits that are slightly too tight. There's some bits I'm not happy with. I think blocking will solve a lot of that. Well, I hope it will. But again, these are for me. So, you know, I'll maybe make a pair for someone else for next Christmas. But right now they're for me. I did add an extra 6 rounds in the ribbing because I like my wrist warmers. I like to be able to put them on and then put whatever I'm wearing on top so that not a breath of wind gets in that bit of wrist, which is why I've made that longer. I also added an extra few rounds. I have a long hand. I added an extra few rounds here just to keep that length. They've got a thumb gusset. I had to learn a couple of new things, make one left and make one right. I've never done that before, or at least I don't remember doing that before. That was in the socks as well. I had to look it up. Yeah, nice gusset. And so I've got the thumb to do. It'll just be a few rounds of rib. And one or two ends. It's not too bad. I did them up to about here, so it's not too bad. I suddenly got carried away last night, and I don't like to do the ends when it's dark anyway. I can't see as well. So I'm really happy with these. It's another pattern by Charlotte Stone. It's called the Christmas Pudding Mitts, and you can find that on Ravelry. That's where I got it. And it's very easy to follow pattern. There's a chart for the colour work. Anything else I want to say about them? Yes, I am joining in with Blueberry Fields _. She has, that's Monique on Instagram. She has a cowl running this month, so you've got until the end of January to knit. I imagine she'll take crochet as well if you're doing crochet mitts, although it is called a cowl, but I imagine she would be inclusive that way. And you have to knit a pair of mitts. Preferably a colour work pair, but not necessarily. So I am going to work fast. I'm going to get this one finished. I did have to frog, by the way. I got the first one to here and I tried it on and it was too big. I'd gone for the biggest size thinking my hands are big. I'm going to need the biggest size. I hadn't swatched or anything. And it really wasn't until I got to about there that you could try it on and see actually, you know, it was hanging off to about here. They were huge on me. So I got to there and had to frog. Good thing about going down a size though, is that they work up faster. So yeah, aren't they cool? I really, really like them. And I know it's too late for Christmas this year, but I thought if I make them now, then I can look them out and wear them in all the way through December and Christmas next year is my plan. Yeah, really like these. Oh, the yarn is, I'm not sponsored by Lovecraft. I just really like this yarn. It's Paintbox yarn again. This one is Sock Solids and it's a typical sock yarn with 75% superwash wool and 25% polyamide, and comes in a range of solid colours and some variegated colours as well. So that is the brown. The red is Javol. I'm not quite sure how I pronounce that. I must look it up because I've used that yarn a lot as well. So the red and the green are bits from my stash of those just little started balls. Here we are. Got these two. This one, which is the... Oh, there's my dad just pulled up. I will have to pause in a minute. This one is... Vicky Brown Designs, and the cream, I don't know. But I'm going to have to pause because the dog is going to go and bark like crazy in a second, and then I'll come back. Hi, I'm back, although to you it will have been no time at all. My dad just popped in with a few things. He lives just 5 minutes away and I could see him coming. and I knew the dog would bark her head off. So I managed to stop that and we're ready to share some crochet. I am joining in the Battenberg underscore 2324 or Battenberg 23 underscore 24. I'll put it up on the screen now that I have had that break. I'm going to be editing anyway, so I can do that. As you know, I prefer to just record the whole thing straight through, no editing. However, if things like that happen, then obviously I will. So I'll be able to put some fancy stuff up on the screen and maybe even share a few photos. We'll see. So this is the Battenberg blanket by Sandra Paul, who is Sandra Cherry Hurt on Instagram and widely online. Most of you will probably know her. And there is a cal running. Or is it a mal? Mal? Cal? Mal? I think it's a mal actually. And because some people are knitting. Some are knitting. Little squares. I mean, it's tiny. Mine are, I haven't measured. I'm guessing about 5 centimetres by 5 centimetres. And it's going to take a lot of squares, which is why it's a 2-year make-along, which is really lovely. There is an Instagram chat group, which has quite a few of my friends and followers in it, which is lovely as well, because everyone's popping photos in, cheering each other on, sharing tips, asking questions about joins and colours and all this kind of thing. So that's really good. I've got a few little squares here to join in. I am using 4-ply. The colourful squares are all from Stash, although I might buy a few mini skeins, we shall see. I do love to knit and crochet socks, so I do have quite a lot of sock yarn kicking about. And for my contrast, I'm using, yes, paintbox yarns. This one came a bit ripped. Paintbox yarn, sock solids, the same as the brown, but this one is in mustard yellow. And I just wanted to do something different. Most folks are doing cream. The pattern suggests cream for these ones. And you know me, I don't like to do what everyone else is doing, so I just wanted to do yellow. I love yellow, I really like the colour, it's bright, it's cheery, and I looked at the scraps that I had in my stash and thought yellow is going to go well with them. Let's come back a bit. Yeah, I love yellow. Put yellow in this scarf. This is one my mum knitted for me, same with a hat by the way. There's someone always asks me, what hat was you wearing? What shawl were you wearing? And I don't always mention. So these are both knitted. I don't know what the patterns are. They were presents from my mum and I've had them for a few years. Anything else I want to say about that? No, I think that's it. I'm just trying to do, maybe not every day. You could do 2 or 3 squares a day, but I am more of a five, six squares every 2 days kind of person. I prefer to do a bundle all at once. So maybe at the weekends I'll get some more done. Maybe there'll be a few days where I don't do any and then I'll catch up. That'll be my way of doing this one. And I might even put it on hold for a month here and there and then just play catch up and work like crazy on it. I know from past blankets and things that I will see it through. I will definitely finish it. I've done a lot of modular blankets like this, including the Hexipuff one, which has 500 little knitted hexagon quilted segments. So I have done 2 of those. So something like this is something that I know that I can commit to and I love it. And yeah, it's nice and small. You know, if you're working, you can be like, yeah, I'll just get a few of these done, and it doesn't take long at all to whip up a wee square and you feel like you've achieved something. That's what I like about them. And the stash busting, of course. I love to stash bust. So yeah, that is a fun project. And alongside that, I've started a journal this year for all my knitting and crochet projects. At the moment it's plain on the front. It's a journal that I picked up from Vent, I think a Bristol-based company, Vent for Change. I think that's where they're from. It's a hardback journal. It's got a little tabby bit for keeping track. I haven't put anything on the inside pages yet. I'm going to decorate these, so that's why I haven't just filled in my name or anything boring like that. I will definitely fill these two pages with my colour, my personality, my style. And I've started project one. This is the Christmas pudding mitts. Sorry, I'll not try not to talk through the journal. Christmas pudding mitts, this is the first page for that. And I decided it would be good to hole punch the different yarns. And then here I've done a wee bit about which each one is. I have used the lark's head knot, I believe that's called. Same as if you were adding tassels to a scarf or something. But I've also stuck a dot of PVA or fabric glue to the knot, just a wee dab on both sides, just to where the actual knot is. Keep that in place because it's quite a big hole and I think they would probably just slip out otherwise. So that is that page. Here's where I had to frog. I got a cool little printer for my Christmas from my husband. It was a surprise present. It's a little cheeky little thing. Now that I've had to edit this video, I'm not going to run and get it. I'll pop a photo in. It's a cute little printer that Bluetooths to your phone, and that's not such a clear photo. It's on pink. Look at this one. I mean, that's pretty decent. So I was able to just print out the photo that I put on Instagram. Looking back, that's going to make it really easy to remember which project's which. So this is the page for the Battenberg blanket. I did a big Battenberg. And then over the page, here is my next project, socks for Jamie. Then this is a pair of socks which are definitely tied up with love because they are black. Dun dun dun, if you know me, I don't like black. I really don't like black. If you know, if you crochet or you knit, black is a pain. But look, I'm doing it. Black, it's Jamie's birthday. At the end of this month, they're going to be 19, and they specifically asked me for a pair of black socks with purple for the contrast. So I'm going to do a purple heel and a purple cuff, and for this I am using, see, I stuck the ball band in my journal. I'm going to have this to hand now for podcasts and I can look stuff up. I'm using Holstgarn Highland, which is a lovely yarn. It's 80% superwash and 20% nylon. And it is so soft and gorgeous to work with. Most sock yarn is 75%, so this one is 80%, and it's got a lovely high twist on it. It's working up beautifully. I'm kind of doing my own thing on this one and using little bits and pieces from various sock patterns. So I've started with Judy's Magic Cast On, and I have the perfect tool, if I say so myself. I mean, I'm not a knitter, so definitely a crocheter. I can knit, but I'm really, really chuffed with that tool. It looks seamless. It feels, I've got my thumb on the inside, it feels seamless as well. It's a gorgeous cast on. Took me about an hour of watching videos over and over and getting used to them. I almost got it right and then I'd make a mistake and then, or maybe make a mistake a few rounds down the line, because I usually cast on all my socks top down, and I usually use Winnick Mum or another sock designer. Almost all the socks I've done, I think barring one pair, have been top down. So this was toe up, which is slightly different for me to get the hang of. A cute wee stitch marker on it. I got some lovely stitch markers and I think they were from Yarnicorn? I'd have to look it up. I don't remember. I'll try and stick it across the screen. With the magic of technology. I cannot remember. A little indie company. And I got quite a few stitch markers from them. And I love this little one with the happy cloud. Because these are going to be happy socks despite the black. But yeah. Not only are they black, Jamie is a UK 14, so they're gonna be, I mean, I'm nowhere near the gusset. We are there. I haven't measured them. If I pull them, does that make them, does that make it go faster? So these are gonna be, I've got 2 weeks. I can do it. It turns out I can work on them in the evening because I've deliberately chosen paler needles and I'm just going round and round. I would probably work the heel in the daylight, although that will be the purple anyway. But if I'm just going round and round in the black, that seems to be okay. Sorry, I'm just watching the dog. Is she all right? Jazzy, you okay? Jazz? Jazz? Come on. Not sure what she's up to. I have a little black working Cocker Spaniel. She's called Jazz, as you probably heard me call her. And she is normally at my side. I'm sitting on a dining chair, otherwise she'd be up beside me. She's my wee friend. Okay, I have one more project to share. It's a new one, started it yesterday. I hinted at it on my stories. And that's as far as I've shared on social media. I've started with just a little swatch. Let's pull some more up. In trebles, rows of treble. I wanted to just see how it was going to drape, and I'm happy with that. I used a 4mm needle. The yarn is from Hobby Yarns. It's their new Friends range. It is extra fine merino, and I imagine, yeah, pardon me, 100% superwash merino, and you get 165 meters per 50 gram ball. So, I've got six colours. This one, and this one. Blush pink, a blue, a pale pink, and I've not got it here, but there is also this green. So this is kind of my colours. Well, these are my colours, never mind the kind of. These are the colours I'm using, and this is the blanket that I'm going to be designing. It's going to be a blanket that I don't know, words! It's going to be a blanket. I'm aiming for a small throw size. There are going to be sections of granny square strips, and then from here, I wonder if I can rest it here and talk about it. Yeah, from here there will be rows worked this way and rows worked this way, and then there'll be another strip of granny squares. I'll change the colours, so there'll be a section in rows and then another strip. And they'll be kind of, it'll probably mirror itself, I think. Although it might, the colours may change. We'll see. I might not mirror it. I haven't thought the entire thing out in my head yet. But yeah, at least three strips of these going across. It might be five. It will certainly be an odd number. And then a border around. What do you think? Ta-da! I am doing a traditional granny. Three colours. And then the only ends I've got, I've sewn in all the pink and the green ones. And then I am joining as you go through the back loops only. I tried it going through both loops, and I just feel this gives it a bit more drape for the blanket. I'm happy with that. Started this yesterday afternoon, very quickly got four squares done. I think it's going to need 15 to 17 across. It was kind of hard to tell on this bit, although I measured one, you know, to get an idea of how many I would need. It's kind of hard to tell how much that would take up. So that is my new project for this year. So that's why I swatched in plain trebles, and I swatched a little square in one colour as well, just to see kind of how this is going to work together. It's not going to be plain rows of treble, don't worry. I'm going to have colour and stripes and a little bit of texture. It's not going to be too textured, I don't think. I don't think it'll be bobbly or puffy or popcorn-y. A little bit of texture, some different stitches to try, and the granny squares. So that is my plan, and I'm going to be working on, it's just these four whips that I have. I've got one that's kind of in hibernation that I'll probably pull out halfway through the year and try and work on that some more. But those are my main ones for now. I need to start a new project page for the new blanket. I'll probably do that this afternoon. I'm really enjoying creating the pages. I used to, you know, when everyone was into the bullet journal phase around 2018, I think everyone took off on it. I think Monday, the 1st of January. Well, the 1st of January 2018 was a Monday, I believe. And I know loads of folks started a bullet journal then. I did. I kept it going that year and into the next year. And then it kind of just petered off. I think I've got my planner now. Is it here on the table? I've got the planner now that I use for my business. It's not as exciting, but it does the job. And this is, since I've pulled it out, the Ultimate Business Planner by Female Entrepreneur School. I totally recommend that. It's got loads of good stuff in it. I use that now. So it's not pretty, but it is practical. So I am really enjoying my new journal because I can do a bit of drawing in it. I can take time over the lettering like I did for the Jamie Sock one. And I'm just enjoying doing something a little bit different. So I think that's all I need to share. Don't forget, once you finish this, to go hop on my mailing list if you haven't already, because you want that free pattern on Monday. And yeah, thank you for watching if you're still around, and I will be back in a couple of weeks with my next episode. So happy crafting, whatever it is you're up to. Bye for now.